Hi YouTube, it's me. I'm back for the first time in a little bit to do a little video that I'm gonna talk about just sort of some of the finds I found over the past 6 months ago for beauty products. My last video I talked about, I had this really super long absence, and I basically explained that it was due to the job that I was working. The long and short of it is I was working like over 60 hours a week, and that is not by any stretch of the imagination, any sort of exaggeration at all. That was legit, 60 plus hours a week. Probably more like 65. So it should not be a surprise that I have decided to leave that job. I, throughout the course of this past school year, really felt like there was a lot of times where I was like, I just don't know if I can do this. And it wasn't the kids. It wasn't even administration or anything like that, even though there were challenges in both of those areas. But honestly, it was just the amount of work. I was teaching 5 grade levels, and it just wasn't giving me really any time at home. Like, that work-life balance was just completely non-existent. So I chose to leave there, and the day after my last day of work, actually, I had a job interview at a Christian school. Which is, what I was doing before. I taught kindergarten at a Christian school, and I interviewed for a position at as a first grade teacher, and I pretty much got offered the job on the spot, and I'm really excited about it. My kids are going to be able to come with me, both of them. The school goes up to 8th grade, so I know we've got a lot of challenges ahead of us. My son, this will be like his fourth new school in the last 4 years, for moving and doing different stuff. But I'm really excited about it. I'm actually nervous. I feel like this job that I had last year really almost gave me like PTSD. I always felt confident that I was good at what I did, and last year really it shook me. Where I didn't feel confident, and I was like, maybe I don't want to do this anymore. Maybe this isn't for me. But I made it through. And I know that some of my students, they found my YouTube channel after my last video. So middle schoolers finding your YouTube video, it was kind of, I don't know, it was embarrassing. I guess it shouldn't, because I'm obviously publishing it, so anyone can look at it. But people I know, especially the kids seeing it was just like, I don't know, it felt really embarrassing. So I know some of them subscribe. So if you are one of my kiddos, I just hope you're having an awesome summer. And I've been thinking about you guys a lot and missing you guys. So mwah. Drop me a comment if one of my kids is watching. Okay, so I have a couple of ideas for videos that I want to do, and I'm gonna break it up probably into maybe 2 or 3 videos. So this first one I want to do, like I said, is gonna be beauty products, and these are gonna be beauty products that I've personally bought over the last probably 6 to 8 months. And then I'm gonna do another video sometime in the next couple days, hopefully, whenever I get a second. About like the best of Ipsy glam bags that I've gotten, because I haven't done a review of ones actually since last August. It's almost been a year. So I went through all of the glam bags, and I picked out the one or two really cool standout products that I want to share with you that I would definitely buy again myself, and I want to just let you know about. All right, so without further delay, I'm just going to be showing you these products that I've picked up. A lot of these I've actually picked up recently. I guess in not being depressed and not being stressed out, I've done a little bit of shopping, which is always something as my little stress relief. But a lot of the stuff I've gotten in the clearance rack, and I'm going to share where I found it. A lot of these, like I said, are more recent finds. So you might even be able to find it near you. Okay, so these first two things I bought last week, and I actually bought them at Target. And I'm almost out of my Garnier BB cream, which I guess Target doesn't carry Garnier there, so I was just kind of looking around to see if there was anything similar, and this is in the clearance rack, and it's from La Roche, which I know is kind of an ex more expensive brand. It was on clearance for $11.98, I believe, and it said that the full price was $38. So I feel like that was a little bit of a score. And this is the Rosa Lilac CC Cream, and it's a complete tone correcting cream, and it's supposed to be for redness, which, you know, when I get pimples and I get redness sometimes. So I've used it a couple times, and it has a really nice smell. It goes on really nicely. And I, like I said, I use the Garnier BB cream. I don't generally use anything too heavy on my face. Maybe if I'm going to a wedding or something, I might put on an actual thicker foundation, but generally I don't. I just use a BB cream, or now I guess the CC cream. So that was on the clearance rack. And next to it, as I was skipping that out, something I've never seen before. And I really love the brand St. Ives. I've been using St. Ives probably so since like middle school, elementary school, with the St. Ives scrub and other products they have. But this one I thought was really cool. It's a St. Ives cleansing stick, rose water, and bamboo. Cleanses away excess oil for instantly shine-free skin. So it looks like this. This was on clearance, I believe, for $3.98. And I said cleansing stick. What's that? First of all, I love rose water. Rose water is something my grandmother always had, and I just love the smell of it. Like the place where I get my eyebrows threaded, they'll put rose water on you afterwards, and just like nostalgic. So anyway, here it is. It's a screw cap. It smells so good, and it's a stick. It almost looks like a deodorant stick. And when you wet your face, you rub this all over. You know, rub it in, rinse it off, and it does just leave a really nice finish to your skin. And I like it. It was on clearance. I don't know if that means it doesn't exist anymore, so I might have to go back to Target. I have to return something, so maybe I'll go back and see if they have this. This is at a Target that wasn't my usual Target. It was a nicer Target, so I don't know if my lowly Target will have it, but this is nice. All right, so those are face products. Now I'm gonna move into lip products, and then eye products. So I have quite a few lip products, and like I said, many of them were good deals. I would say 90% of the stuff I bought at TJ Maxx, Marshalls, or Nordstrom Rack. Those are where I go, because I love designer makeup. I almost exclusively use designer lips and eye makeup. And I never pay full price for anything. I think of all the things I've gotten, maybe I've paid full price for maybe one or two of them. And a lot of it honestly has come from Ipsy. So I'll share some of those things with you. All right, so I saw this, I believe it was TJ Maxx or Marshalls, and it's Too Faced, and it's from their Peach line. And I was feeling very adventurous when I got this. I wanted a really dark color. And a dark color I got, because this is was really dark. It's called Love is a Battlefield. It smells like peaches. Their whole line smells like peaches. That's dark, guys. Like real dark. Now on, it's not quite as severe. Sorry, the lighting in here is horrible. I want it to be in my office, but my kid is still talking to himself up there, talking himself into bed. But it's still darker than I usually do. So this is like a strictly winter, dark, vampy vibes type deal. So Love is a Battlefield, George Peach. Now this one I actually got maybe about 2.5, 3 weeks ago. We were just in Florida and I bought it right before that trip. And it was Marshall's, and you can see it was $3.50. And it's the Vice Urban Vices Lip Kit. And I generally don't like things like this because it's like, you know, when you have to have a little brush and everything, it's kind of cumbersome to carry around. But this I actually really like because it is long wear lipstick. So if I'm putting it on before I go out somewhere, I'm probably not going to need to reapply any lip color because I generally don't go out for too long. So here it is, four colors and a little brush. Let me not blind you. And I've kind of been just sort of mixing it around to make my own tones. And they're called Pandemonium, Wrath, Hex, and Backtalk. I really like the back talk. You can see I've been dipping into that one a little bit. So this is at my Marshalls for $3.50. The last time I was there, which was about 2 days ago, they still had them. So check that out. All right, now I have discovered Something else from the Urban Decay Vice line that I am absolutely obsessed with, and it is their Vice liquid lipsticks. This one, I think I got maybe around Christmas time. I thought it was going to be like, some sort of hot pink, clear shimmer. I didn't really know too much about this line, and I was very highly mistaken because these babies are highly pigmented and they dry matte. So I put it on. I always test stuff out at home before I try to like debut it anywhere. And I was like, oh no, I can't wear this anywhere. So there it is. The color is called Big Bang. And I have worn it maybe like twice for things at school, like a wacky Wednesday or something crazy. Because to me, this is way too crazy for me to actually wear out in public, like for serious. And I kind of forgot about it after that. I used it one or two times. And then I was at Nordstrom Rack. And I always go to their clearance sections first. Of any store, I go to clearance section first. And these were in the clearance section, and they had a ton of them. So I actually bought a bunch for myself and to resell. So I believe I sold some, but mostly I've kept for myself some of them. And I do still have some for sale in my closet also. So I'm going to show you. This one's my favorite one. It's the one I'm wearing right now, and it's called Back Talk. They all have sassy names, so this is called Back Talk. Another one that I really like, which is along the same lines, if this one has a little darker and has some more shimmer, it's called Amulet. And these are good everyday colors. Nothing too crazy. This next one is one of the colors I have for sale in my closet. It is fairly dark. This one's called Conspiracy. Okay. And I haven't actually worn this one yet, but I think this is going to be more of a winter color. It's going to be along the lines of that lipstick I showed you. Yeah, it's kind of dark. Got some shimmer to it, like the first one. And this last one I just picked up the other day at my Marshalls. And this one was on clearance for $4. It's called WSM. So, does that have some sort of weird meaning I don't know about? I'm always afraid about that stuff. Like, what's some weird sex meaning I don't know about? And I really like this one. This actually reminds me of something that I got in my Ipsy. I really like that. I think it's like separating already and going bad, which is really upsetting. What's this one right there? Like a purpley type color. Highly, highly, highly recommend these. And this one, I think, was $4. I do have, like I said, I do have some of them. I think I have all three of these colors actually for sale in my Poshmark closet. And I actually, I did give some as teachers' gifts too because I'm obsessed with them. So I'm like, I'll share some of these liquid lipsticks with my kids' teachers. All right. So moving on from that, I had gotten one of these melted lip things in a kit a long time ago. So when I saw this, I had to snatch it up. And this one is chocolate honey. It smells like hot chocolate. It's incredible. And it has a really nice brown, perfect for winter. Love it. All right, now this kind of bridges the gap between lips and eyes. Around Christmas time, maybe it was Black Friday, I don't remember. I had seen a coupon code for Ulta.com, and I bought an Urban Decay Naked Cherry Vault. Now the vaults are really expensive. They're normally around $100. But with my coupon code, I believe it was 70 or 75, which still sounds expensive, but when you break down what was actually in it was actually really cheap. It came with three of these full-size lipsticks. Now these lipsticks are about $18 each, so right there, that's almost $60. And again, some of these colors are a little out there for me. I don't know if I'd wear them to work, but maybe for a night out where I want to just have a more dramatic look. This one's called Cherry. dark, guys. A lot of these remind me of the lipsticks that my sister wore in the 90s that I wanted to wear, but I was not allowed to because I was like in fifth grade. So there's Cherry right there. It's a dark bun. Now this one is called Devilish. It kind of reminds me of that crazy lip gloss that I showed you. It's actually slightly more subdued, but it is really glittery. Again, very 90s. Right there, not too crazy. Okay, and then this one that I've worn a bunch of times that I like is the more me color. This one's called Juicy. It's like a almost like a more nude sparkly one. I don't even know if it's gonna show up in this crazy light. Okay, and then of course to go with the vault is the palette. This is my second full-size Naked palette. I have the Smoky palette and I have a small Naked Basics, I think is what it is, palette as well, but this is my second full-size one. And honestly, I didn't spend full price on the other one either, but I would say that if you were into makeup, this is definitely worth the investment if you were thinking about paying full price for any of their products with these Naked palettes. So here we go. Now, some of these colors, you could tell I've used more than others. And I do tend to go for more nude, but I did sort of break out and use some of these more pink rose hues, especially like as the bottom layer of my eyeshadow. So there it is. You can see my chandelier. I'm in my dining room. And the colors are Hot Spot, Caution, Bang Bang, Feels, Juicy, like the lipstick. Turn On and Ambitious. These two I probably use the most out of here. Thing, Devilish, Young Love, I like. Drunk Dial, I also like. It's very brown. And Privacy. So all in all, I mean, I think this palette itself goes for like 60 something dollars. So to get the three lipsticks in this palette, definitely worth it. I've gotten a lot of good deals around Black Friday, so you know, be checking, be looking. Alright, so this, I have two more things left I want to show you. I'm going to wrap it up. This is a Too Faced Chocolate Bonbons. I have one other chocolate. It's another mini chocolate. It's the mini white chocolate. And then I have several other Too Faced palettes. I do like Too Faced palettes. I would say generally from my experience, I think that overall I've had better experience with the Urban Decay. I feel like Urban Decay is more pigmented for the most part, especially with their lighter colors. I feel like some of these Too Faced lighter colors, they just don't leave as much color as I would personally like. That being said, I really like this palette and I love, 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 love the next palette I'm going to show you, and they're both Too Faced. Okay, so this is the Chocolate Bonbons. I got this at Nordstrom's Rack for $20. I did see the regular Too Faced chocolate and I was tempted at Marshall's the other day also for $20. My Marshall's also had and I don't know about TJ Maxx, I didn't look in their makeup section, but my Marshalls also had the Naked 2 Basics kit and other stuff for around $20. So you always have to go through and make sure stuff's not broken, which is always the problem with these places. But just throwing it out there, my stores had an awesome selection this last time I went. All right, so I really, really like the colors of this one. Like I said, the pigmentation of this particular kit is pretty good. No complaints as I've had with other ones. So here it goes. This one, like I said, was $20, and I think for $20, you really do get a lot of color. And you also get, I think these longer strips are for highlighting. If I'm not mistaken, I do use them as eyeshadow also. All right, so try not to blind you. All right, so the colors we have are called Almond Truffle, Satin Sheet, Sprinkles, Molasses Chip, Malted, Cashew Chew, Cotton Candy, Cafe Au Lait, Bordeaux, mocha, black currant, dark truffle, pecan, praline, totally fudge, Earl Grey, and divinity. I mean, you can see which ones I've used, which ones I haven't. I really like this palette. I think it has a lot of really good selections. You got pinkies, you have browns, you have like this black currant color is really, really pretty. Actually, we were just in Florida, and of all of the palettes I could have picked, I picked this one. We were trying to pack light, and I didn't want to overdo it with makeup, so I picked this one because I felt like I had a good selection for colors I might want to use. So, I like this one. It's a good one. All right, last but not least, I picked this guy up at Nordstrom Rack last week. It was $20. My Nordstrom Rack had an awesome selection of different palettes there as well. They had the Too Faced Rainbow palette. They had a ton of MAC palettes. I think one was called that I was looking at was called Basic Bitch, but I liked this one better. They had just a ton of stuff. And they had some things by Lorac, I think. I don't know. When I saw this one and I saw the price, I was like, wow, I need to get this because it was something that I had wanted to get. And I had heard a lot of really good things about it. And like I said, even though I haven't had a great relationship with Too Faced with their eyeshadows, the lighter colors, I thought I'd give this a try. And this one's really, really good. I would say the best of the ones that I own, and I own like three or, I guess, four or five now. So this is the White Peach. And it is infused with peach and sweet fig cream, whatever that means. The lighting is horrible, so you can't tell, but I'm wearing it right now. It's very the peachy colors. When you look at them actually in the palette, you might be like, whoa, they're orange. But actually, they really look very natural and very nice on. And for me, especially going to work, being with kids, and now I'm gonna be back with little kids, like I don't want to wear anything too crazy, too dramatic. I want to wear makeup because I like to wear makeup, but I don't want to look like I'm going to a concert or going to a club or something. It's just not what I want to wear. So, anyways, here it is. Like I said, I think this one was $20, which I think is really good. I think all of the Too Faced palettes they had there were $20. The MAC palettes and the Urban Decay palettes, they were all 25 and up. So the colors we have here are peach cream, peach suede, peaches and dreams, creme de la peach, peach sorbet, glistening peach, which I've already hit like almost every day since I got it, peach smoothie, sweet fig, peach ice, fuzzy, on the grill, and peach passion. So this is another one that I think we have another trip coming up. And I'll probably bring this one with me because it just has a lot of variety to it. So that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully within the next couple days I'll be able to get out that other video just of like the really cool things I've gotten in my Ipsies lately. Different products that I think are definitely worth mentioning and checking out. Thanks.